Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. My name's Noelle and I do unboxings here, mostly lifestyle subscription boxes, but also some stationery, books, beauty, jewelry, and even a dash of Disney. So if you like unboxings, I do hope you'll consider subscribing to my channel and hitting the notification bell. As always, if you're already subscribed, thanks again so much for being here and welcome back. Today I have my winter Pusheen box to share with you, and if it seems like I just opened Pusheen box, it's because it was just a few weeks ago that I received and opened my fall Pusheen box, which came in a dark blue glossy box. To be honest, I was a little bit disappointed by the quality of a lot of the products in that box, except for the velour pullover, which is something I've been wearing constantly because it is so soft and so cozy. But I'm very happy to see that they are right back on track in terms of their shipping schedule. And we're back to the beautiful like satin finish gray box that is styled to look just like Pusheen, which is this adorable cartoon gray tabby cat, very kawaii. This box is put out by Culture Fly. It is $43.95 per season plus $6 in shipping, which I think is well worth the price as long as you like a couple of the items. And it is always items that are exclusive to this box, so it's kind of fun for collectors. I just think the box itself is always really cute. It always goes with whatever the theme is for that season. This time though, it is their 10-year anniversary, the 10-year anniversary of Pusheen. So we've got that like noted in this little star over here. But the box is just so cute to keep a hold of all of those collector's items. We've got her little feet on the bottom, we've got a little tail on the back, and I usually do hold on to these to store the items that I don't have an immediate use for. And it is definitely a fandom where there are a lot of collectors, so if you do receive items that you don't necessarily want to collect yourself or hold on to, you can usually find like a Facebook group where you can buy, sell, or trade. So all right, you guys, inside we've got all of these gorgeous like pastel colors, very like classic Pusheen. Again, the packaging they do is always really good. They always size the box so it all like fits in here like perfectly, and I can never get it to fit in quite perfectly again. But they do include a little product card, and this one is cute. It's got Pusheen with a little cupcake, and it looks like we have got 9 items in this box. So I'm gonna go ahead and prop this up in front of me. Generally, there is a vinyl collector like little figurine. I don't really collect those, but I've kind of held on to them because I feel like eventually I'll probably sell them or gift them to someone who will really enjoy them. All right, you guys, let's go ahead and look at that vinyl figurine that we've got. And this one is very like classic Pusheen, who is often styled with different food that she enjoys. And this one's so cute. She's got a little donut. So I'm not someone who keeps mine in the box. If I was going to have them out and displayed somewhere, which I don't at the moment, I would definitely take them out of the box. That would be me if I like collected Funkos or something too. So very cute. I like that this one is a little bit smaller. Some of the figurines we've been getting in recent boxes have been like really big, where even if I did have some display space, like it would take up a lot of it. So very, very cute. Here she is with her little frosted donut with stars, cute little face, little whiskers kind of stick out there. You can see it's very three-dimensional. She is a very thick cat. We've got the stripes and the little tail on the back. So very, very cute little item. I'm gonna go ahead and put her right back over there and try to make space here on my desk for all of these boxes. Now there is usually an apparel item in the Pusheen box. Like I said, I love that velour pullover that I just got in the last box. I did see the spoiler for the item that's in this box, and I'm not like super thrilled about it, honestly. It kind of goes back and forth like every other season. I really like the apparel item. In the past, we've gotten a really pretty like silk robe that I thought was nice too. But this one, I'm like, I kind of feel so about it. So it is a crew neck sweatshirt. We got one last year, and it was like yellow with like an embossed like design. This one, I'm just not like a fan of the color blocking. I don't like this like kind of like saccharine pink. It's not like my thing. I think that this little embroidered Pusheen here with a roll of sushi is actually adorable. And if they had just done like a white sweatshirt without the pink sleeves, I think I would have been way more into it, because then I could have like cropped it, maybe like cut out the neck, just done something a little bit different with it. I get why it's a sweatshirt, because it is the winter box, but the pink sleeves, like, it's not like the best like design in my personal opinion. And like, again, it's very, very pink, and this is supposed to be an adult box. It's also supposed to be like a unisex box, and I feel like, you know, even though guys can totally wear pink, I feel like this is very, very feminine. So Anyway, not my favorite apparel item, but it just says, show people how you roll in this perfectly soft crew neck sweatshirt. Get it? Roll. So they're very punny in this box. So not my favorite apparel item, but it does feel nice and soft inside. So I will find someone who will enjoy it. I still sometimes wear the yellow one that I got last year too. All right, so this is kind of cute. We got some salt and pepper shakers. So let's see what the quality is like on these. Like I said, the last box, some of this stuff just felt a little bit like janky to me, like not the best quality. I mean, I know all of this is kind of like whimsical stuff. It's not like meant to last a lifetime, but you want it to be like somewhat quality. So this one already seems nicer just in the packaging. It's all nestled in some foam and they do appear to be glass. It says this set of Pusheen and Stormy salt and pepper shakers will brighten up any kitchen. So they are glass. So here is Stormy. That's Pusheen's friend. I love that it's a gold top. I just think that's kind of fun. You guys know that I love gold accents because I think it makes things a little bit fancier. So there she is with a burger. And then Pusheen over here has got a big old slice of pizza. And pizza is one of my favorite like indulgent dinners or lunches or breakfasts. Really, I just like pizza. So this is a really cute set. And it is glass, which I'm happy to see. Sometimes they do like plastic items. And those are never like really like the best quality, obviously, because they're gonna like scratch and like break and crack. And so I'm happy to see that those were glass. So that's a nice item, actually. Don't know that I'll be putting them in my kitchen. Doesn't really go with the decor, but that's all right. So we did get a plush, and I feel like you only get like a plush maybe like, I think it used to be more common to receive the plushes in the Pusheen box, and now it's maybe like every 3 boxes. I think this is only the second one that I've received, and I've probably been subscribed to this box for like 5 or 6 seasons, but I think they're really, really cute. They're totally not functional at all, but they are super duper soft. The like material that they make them out of just makes them like a nice little stress ball. So I just have to fluff up her whiskers a little bit better because they get a little bit smooshed in the plastic bag. So we'll fix her whiskers, but she's just holding on to this big old slice of like pastel pizza. And it's kind of weird to me that the pepperonis are shaped like stars, but I guess that's kind of like the theme for this anniversary box. Here's your little tail in the back. Got little stripes kind of embroidered in there. So let's see what it says about this. You caught this mini Pusheen plush mid-bite. Maybe she'll share. So it doesn't look like she's actually taken a bite quite yet. But again, these are definitely collector's items. It even says on the tag, 10th anniversary pizza Pusheen. So I probably will. I've already taken it out of the plastic, obviously. But I'll probably go ahead and keep that tag on there. It does feel like there's some like bean bags like in the stuffing on the bottom so she can sit nicely on a shelf. So that's good. All right, what else? Ooh, something that makes sense for the end of the year. We have the box itself got a little bit dented, but it says it is an easel desk calendar, and I love desk calendars. I don't like to have big ones on my walls because I have a very limited space to hang art and everything, but I love having the ease of looking at a calendar on my desk because I'm always like trying to figure out what, you know, 3 weeks from today is, or like the second Wednesday of the month. And so it's really nice to have a little desk calendar. So I do have a little like desk vacuum that came from this box past season. So I think it'll be nice to have a little matching calendar. Let me see if I can put this down. So this again seems like much better quality than the last box. It's just got this little wood stand, right, with the slot. And then we have all of these cards with Pusheen for all of the months of the year for 2021, which I know we are all eagerly awaiting. So you just put that in the stand and it just sits up just like this. And of course you could use this stand for other like desk calendar cards or postcards or anything that you want to display, but I think that is a great little item, and I will probably be using this throughout the year unless I find something else that I want to use or alternate with. It says this wood easel calendar is adorable and perfect for your workspace, and I really, really like that. I don't know that I can put that back in the box because the box kind of folded interestingly. All right, we've got a couple more items. So I'm already so much happier with this box than the last one, even though I really loved the theme of the last box. All right, so it looks like we've got a cotton mesh tote bag. So I might not pull this out, but you guys can see it's just one of those like net bags. And I think the only thing that makes it Pusheen is this little like rubberized charm. I'll probably take it out actually. So it says, use this stylish and reusable mesh bag on your next grocery trip. I don't usually use these kinds of bags. I've gotten them in all kinds of different subscriptions in terms of like, you know, you're supposed to use them, I think, for like the farmer's market. market when you're being super eco-conscious and, you know, it holds your, like, fruit nicely. Just for, like, general shopping, though, I feel like everything just kind of falls through and it seems a little bit dangerous. They really love this color yellow with, like, Pusheen-styled things. It doesn't feel like the strongest netting, so I don't even know if you'd want to put a lot of produce in there, but it is cute. You could definitely take it to the beach. It'd be good to, like, throw, like, a small towel in or something. And then, like I said, the only thing that makes it Pusheen is this little rubberized, like, keychain, this little bag charm, which I think is great because if you don't want it to be a Pusheen bag, then it's not. You just take this off and you can actually put this little bag charm on something else that you do want to style with Pusheen. But useful to have, easy to store. I can put this with all of my other reusable bags and you never know when I might want to use it. Especially, like, this bright yellow color could be fun for the spring or the summer. So let's see what else we have. We have something with pom-poms, and I do love a good pom-pom, so let me see if I can open this up. I'm just kind of, like, piling everything here in my lap, you guys, so hopefully we don't have any disasters and have things fall to the floor. It says, this light garland is perfect for your next holiday party. So I love getting, like, fairy lights and stuff in subscription boxes, especially the kind where you don't actually have to plug it in and just has this little battery box. So this is so cute! So it's pom-poms with little sparkly lights, and then we've got these little, I guess the lights are actually little Pusheens that light up. So there's not too many of them. It's like every three pom-poms you get a Pusheen. But I think this is really cute, and I will definitely show you guys this all lit up over on Instagram, which is where I like to do a lot of product flat lays and product close-ups. But I think this is really, really cute, and again, decent quality, definitely something that you can store just if you want to feel a little festive. It would be really cute, like, in a kid's room for sure, so I'm happy with that item. It's so cute. So I'm not, like, super into, like, the palette that they chose, all these pastels, but I get it. It's like a kawaii subscription and it totally makes sense, and it always goes with Pusheen gray. All right, let's see. Still a couple more items. We have got a melamine plate set of two, so that's kind of fun. I know, again, you guys, this is technically considered an adult box. You can't get any of the apparel items in kids' sizes. But I feel like if you like Pusheen or you are someone who likes kawaii characters and things, then you kind of understand that sometimes it's stuff that can be used by kids too. So let's see. You know, melamine plates, though, are great to have. I love having, like, disposable paper plates, but I also just love having, like, plates that you can take outdoors or that you can take, like, in your cooler if you're going somewhere for a little picnic, and it just kind of elevates things, and it's nice to have things that are reusable. I don't know why I was trying so hard to take the second plate out. They are identical. Oh, but here we go. We've got Pusheen with yet another favorite food, which is ice cream, which is cute. It's got a little ice cream cone with a little star on top instead of a cherry, and then it's got those little lines around. So it's a normal size plate. It's not, like, the thickest melamine, but again, it's a good reusable plate, which I think is cute, and you could definitely do, like, a little party, like a little, like, tea, afternoon tea with this whole set. It says, these melamine plates are the greatest thing since sliced pizza, which is kind of funny because then it's got, like, an ice cream cone on it. But I'm looking and I'm like, yeah, even the one that they picture here has the ice cream cone, so it's surprising that they mentioned pizza, but I guess we always have this little Pusheen that we can stick right on top of that plate if we want to. We have one more item. Like I said, you guys, this is such a better box, and it could just be because it is their 10th anniversary, so maybe the value is a little bit higher than usual. And the last item that I have to share with you is these stemless shatterproof glasses. So I'm pretty excited. I'm wondering if by shatterproof, though, they mean that it's plastic, which is fine. You know, I could probably still shatter them if I tried. but they do have this nice styrofoam packing. Let me see. They actually feel like glass. I am shocked by that. But let me see if I can pull them out carefully. They're in here, like, upside down. I'm trying not to do too many of those terrible styrofoam noises for you guys. So I don't know. See, they're, like, kind of wedged in here, and I don't know if I can get them out easily without, like, breaking the styrofoam, which I definitely don't want to do. Let's see if I can kind of crack these guys open. The answer is no, they do not want to come out. Let's see. So let's see what it says. Cheers to a new year with these stemless drinking glasses. So of course you can cheers with anything. They just look like little like tumblers more so than like wine glasses or anything. So I'm going ahead and like breaking the styrofoam, which I'm probably going to be bummed that I did, but so that I can show it to you, even though I could have just waited to do it over on Instagram. Let me just wipe these off. So the only thing that I'm seeing with these glasses, which again, they are glass, which is great, is you can kind of see that they just basically put a sticker on them. So my sticker isn't very clear. It looks like you can actually see where the sticker was applied. Maybe with an easy washing that won't be as noticeable, but right now it makes the whole glass look kind of cloudy. So this time Pusheen has got a nice big burger. I love her little feet there along the bottom, but it looks like even my sticker, you can kind of see the edge, you guys. It's applied like super crooked, so it's kind of weird to me, and it's a bummer to me that that's how they decided to put that image on there instead of actually printing it directly on the glass that they slapped a sticker on. So I'll have to see if the other one looks good too. They have actually been really great. There's been a few times where I've received slightly damaged products, and they have always sent me a replacement super duper quick, but this just might be because of the style of application on these glasses, which is a bummer. I do think these are cute. I would probably find myself using them every once in a while, but I'm not sure if it's worth me having them replaced, because again, the second set that they send me might be exactly the same. I'll have to take a look at the other glass and see. Maybe it's just a fluke and it's just on this one, but let me know, you guys, what your favorite item in this box was. I think for me, it's probably that desk calendar, just because it is actually really useful. And then for fun stuff, I think that the little garland is really cute, the little string lights. And then in terms of like functional and also well-made, I think the salt and pepper shaker is adorable. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please do give it a thumbs up, and hopefully I see you all really, really soon in my next unboxing.